from fatal accidents to traumatic experiences. This is what happens when MRIs go wrong. Today's video was requested by Business Trending. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 5. Rajesh Maru. In 2018, Indian man Rajesh Maru was visiting an elderly relative at Mumbai's Nair Hospital. According to his family, a staff member asked Maru to carry an oxygen cylinder inside the room with the MRI scanner. The person in question reportedly assured Maru's family that the machine had been turned off. This, unfortunately, wasn't the case. As he carried the metal cylinder inside, Maru was yanked towards the machine with great force. The tank was damaged by the impact and started leaking liquid oxygen, which Maru inhaled. He was rushed to the emergency room but was pronounced dead within 10 minutes. In the aftermath, arrests were made and the victim's family was compensated. Next up, we've got several police officers who were disarmed by MRI scanners. But first, let's learn more about how these machines work. Magnetic resonance imaging, or MRI, is a medical imaging technique used to observe the physiological processes and anatomy of the human body. The MRI scanner is a large cylindrical machine which creates a strong magnetic field around the body. Although the machine is complex, the way it works is quite simple to grasp. Once a person is inside the narrow tube, the scanner sends pulses of radio waves which knock hydrogen nuclei out of their regular position. Since we're mostly made of water, hydrogen atoms are abundant in the body. In the MRI scanner, instead of spinning randomly, hydrogen atoms line up with the magnetic field. When the magnetic field is turned off, the nuclei return to their normal position and, in doing so, send out radio signals. A computer then analyzes these signals and converts them into images of the organ or body structure that's been examined. It's a highly effective procedure, but one that also comes with several risks, particularly since it involves the use of powerful electromagnets. Before we continue with our list, answer this question. Which of these activities was performed in an MRI machine for scientific observation? A. Writing poetry. B. Solving a Rubik's Cube. C. Speaking backwards. D. Having intercourse. Let us know what you think in the comments section below and keep watching to find out the right answer. Number 4. MRIs and Guns. In 2013, an unnamed police officer in rural Illinois was investigating a burglary inside a medical building. As he entered the MRI room, his service weapon was forcefully pulled to the machine. The gun remained immovable and the building was locked down. The situation was only resolved after the machine's manufacturer was contacted for assistance. Oddly enough, the 2013 incident wasn't the first time that an MRI scanner had disarmed a police officer. In 2009, a police officer was visiting her mother when her firearm was pulled to the machine, thus trapping her hand as well. She managed to get free, but the weapon was stuck to the machine for hours. Then again in 2006, an off-duty officer in New York carried a gun into the MRI room during his examination. The weapon was pulled to the machine and released a bullet into the wall. Fortunately, nobody was hurt. Our next listing involves a severe injury suffered by an elderly war veteran. Before we get to that though, let's see what an MRI scanner can actually be used for. The MRI scanner is among the best diagnostic tools available in medicine today. Since its development in the 1970s and 80s, it has gradually evolved to include more processes. One of these is observing the functional activity in the brain by measuring changes in blood flow. Diffusion MRI is used to observe how water molecules move through the body since strokes or tumors may restrict their diffusion. Developed in the early 2000s, real-time MRI can be used for continuous observation of moving organs, like the heart. MRI can also be combined with high-intensity focused ultrasound therapy. This non-invasive technique uses high-energy beams to remove diseased tissue, and the process may be monitored through magnetic resonance. Aside from its wide variety of applications, it's also worth mentioning that unlike CT or CAT scans, MRI doesn't use X-ray or ionizing radiation. Number 3. Dan Mahoney. 79-year-old war veteran Dan Mahoney was seriously injured in a radiology center in Medford, New York. According to Mahoney's son, the man had been informed about the dangers of bringing metal objects inside the MRI room, yet nobody told him to leave his metal walker behind. It was yanked from under Mahoney as soon as the elderly man entered the room. He fell to the floor abruptly and hit his head. 2 days later, he suffered a stroke, and roughly 2 months later, he was dead. Mahoney's family subsequently sued the hospital. Before we get to one of the most brutal incidents to have ever taken place inside an MRI room, let's go through some of the ways a scanner can kill you. Before we move on, official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. It's out of this world. Although rare, MRI-related fatalities have occurred, mostly as the result of human error. Since high-powered magnets are used, anything metal on or inside the body can basically become a deadly projectile. Internally, this includes anything from pacemakers, screws, plates, or surgical clips to shrapnel or bullets. These objects can heat up, become displaced, or in rare cases, even get forcefully pulled out of the body. Minuscule metal fragments in the eye may cause tissue damage or even blindness. It's worth mentioning that MRI magnets are at least 1,000 times more powerful than refrigerator magnets. If something metal is brought inside the room, it will be drawn to the inside of the scanner where the patient is sitting. The greater the mass of the metal object and the closer it is to the machine, the more dangerous it becomes. Substances known as contrast dyes may be administered through an IV to improve the imaging quality. Some patients may suffer allergic reactions to these substances. Additionally, the loud sounds, the confined space, and the pressure to sit still may cause anxiety attacks. Number 2. Michael Colombini. 6-year-old Michael Colombini died after sustaining severe skull trauma at the Westchester Medical Center north of New York City. The incident took place in 2001. Prior to going in the MRI scanner, the boy had undergone surgery to remove a benign tumor. His kindergarten teacher told a media outlet, "You'd think that if you'd survived all of that, you'd be sort of home free." The MRI scan was a way for doctors to monitor the boy's progress after the surgery. Even though the dangers of having anything metal in the room were part of the safety protocols, a metal oxygen tank somehow made its way inside. As the 10-ton electromagnet was turned on, the tank was pulled towards the tube. At 20 to 30 feet per second, the flying cylinder crushed the boy's skull, causing fractures and bruising to his brain. He later succumbed to his injuries. In light of this tragic incident, let's go through some MRI safety measures. After that, we'll take a look at a case involving two hospital workers pinned down by an oxygen tank for 4 hours. From the perspective of medical professionals, safety is a matter of following the proper regulations when operating the MRI machine. These may differ slightly depending on the country where the machine is used, but the overall safety protocol is usually the same. As a patient, you should inform your doctor if you have any metal implants or foreign objects in your body. Remove all jewelry, piercings, and other metal objects before you go inside the room with the scanner. Tell your doctor if you suffer from claustrophobia, which is the fear of being enclosed in a tight space. Anti-anxiety medication may be provided to ease your MRI experience. You should also notify the radiologist or technician of any known allergies. So what activity was performed in an MRI scanner for scientific observation? The right answer was D, having intercourse. In the late 1990s, a Dutch researcher named Peck van Andel and his team studied several couples as they had intercourse in an MRI scanner. It was reportedly done to observe bodily functions during heterosexual relations. Number 1. Incident in Mumbai. In November 2014, two hospital workers in Mumbai spent roughly 4 hours sandwiched between a metal oxygen tank and an MRI machine. As they were preparing the machine for a scan, technician Swami Ramaya asked ward boy Sunil Jadhav to bring him an oxygen mask. Jadhav, who'd never worked in an MRI room, misunderstood and brought him a 4-foot oxygen tank instead. As Jadhav approached the machine, he was yanked with such brute force that he didn't have time to drop the tank. Both he and Ramia were pinned against the MRI machine. It would have been over in a matter of minutes, but the scanner's emergency stop didn't work and the magnetic field remained active. Therefore, the men were stuck to the scanner for about 4 hours. Jadhav had suffered a fractured shoulder, while Ramia had suffered a ruptured bladder, kidney damage and internal bleeding. The men were treated while they were still pinned to the machine. According to local reports, a team of rescuers at one point tried to remove the cylinder using a rope. The effort proved futile and the men were only released after an engineer working for the scanner's manufacturer arrived on site. Both of them eventually recovered and were compensated in the incident's aftermath. It would take almost a year for Ramia to return to his work, and he was reportedly traumatized by what had happened. Thanks for watching. Would you rather be stuck in an MRI machine for 5 hours or be subjected to constant jump scares for that same amount of time? Let us know in the comments section below.